But Christian, you know, you've worked with the former president, and we saw him before looking very defiant, but also very angry, I'd have to say, about what has been handed down here. How do you think that he is personally reacting and feeling about what has happened today?
Yeah, it's usually not a big mystery what President Trump is doing. I mean, he's usually very candid about his beliefs on social media. So very angry and disappointed. I think, you know, there was some thought that at least you'd have a hung jury, that at least some of the jurors would be skeptical. After all, they had to ask for the judge to read his convoluted instructions back again. But I think you'll see a resolve. Also, this is, you know, this is the last trial that will play out before the election. So who knows what this judge, who's a very politicized judge, will do, whether he'll try and keep Trump in New York as sentencing matters are addressed, or whether this now just gets turned over broadly to the public. You know, I think you'll see a very, very determined president. The question is, too, is whether he decides to be magnanimous to his former home state of New York, or whether he chooses to be vengeful once in office. It's very easy for a president to start pulling back some of the many, many, many federal funds that New York City relies on to operate, to stay viable.
Yeah, and you know, you mentioned, though, the political nature of this trial, and this stood out to me, and I want to get your reaction, because an awful lot of people are saying, and Alvin Bragg, the DA, has said, this isn't about politics, this is just about following the law, and yet they've set sentencing for July 11th, just a few days before Trump is to be confirmed officially as the Republican nominee at the Republican National Convention. Does that data point to you kind of give away the game that this is really about, well, what they're accusing Trump of, election interference?
Exactly. It is election interference. This seems like an expedited basis. Usually there's a significant amount of time between, especially on a novel case like this without precedent, you think there would be a significant amount of time between conviction and sentencing. This is what the Biden administration is counting on. They're hoping against hope that this is going to have some sort of effect that Biden has been unable to achieve. He's below water in all of the polls, the economy, foreign policy, the direction of the country. People still blame him for inflation. They blame him for a lower quality of life. And it looks just like it's ongoing politics by this judge and by the other judges in cases against Trump.
Do you think that voters, though, I mean, in the Trump camp, in their discussions about going forward, this badge, they're going to hang this, you know, Donald Trump is a felon badge on the former president as he campaigns. Now, clearly he doesn't think this is going to hurt him, and in fact, it may help him. But is there a danger at all that some people will look at this and say, well, Trump's got these troubles, Biden is a mess for a whole number of other reasons, but we're just going to wind up staying home? Is there a turnout issue that you're concerned about here, an enthusiasm gap?
Not an enthusiasm gap. There were polls that were taken sort of generically before. If there were a candidate who were a convicted felon, would you be less likely to vote for him? And people did say yes, they would be less likely to vote. However, now that you're into a specific case of Trump being convicted of these very difficult to understand fraud charges, convictions now, I don't think you'll have that effect. And in fact, the base, I think, will be very, very fired up. And also the new voters that Donald Trump has had success in bringing into the Republican fold, especially Blacks and Latinos. Certainly within the Black community, there is a current of injustice and of reaction to that. And in that case, you may have more Black sympathy for Donald Trump in seeing that he has been persecuted and had the judicial system used against him. And if you look at swing states, Pennsylvania, Michigan in particular, Ohio is not really a swing state anymore, that's more reliably Republican. They're not Black majority states, but a significant Black vote. And the Democrats have been terrified that that voting bloc that they've taken for granted seems to be eroding. And Donald Trump isn't necessarily winning a majority, but certainly among Black men is doing better. And in fact, that this this case, this sense of persecution of someone who's being treated unfairly and of a choice that's being taken away or trying to be taken away from voters and given to officials, actually, again, will help Donald Trump.